we value capability and who a person is more than specific skills. And so even though I didn't have a finance or investing background, I think Bridgewater saw potential in me and I saw an opportunity to try something different.
I joined the macro team and was, you know, tracking developed world growth and inflation, then moved over to what was the emerging markets team, and found myself really drawn to that kind of work, mostly because I come from a part of the world that is still developing and still growing, where the asset markets are still pretty small and nascent.
It was just addictive how fast, you know, you could really feel the impact, whether it was, you know, our clients that are these huge pools of money around the world that makes a big difference, what happens to them, for them who are pensions, their beneficiaries, the distance between an idea to actually making money in the markets and getting the feedback.
It feels like standing on the shoulders of giants, right? Like, I feel very fortunate to be able to represent a firm who, like, you sit down at the table and there's immediate brand recognition and it's admirable and it's favorable.
I was given this goal of servicing this client book. It was a new client book. Figure out a way to service them excellently, bring them the best of Bridgewater, do it in a leverageable way. And we haven't done this before. Like, here's a problem, go figure it out. And I got to build this whole service model, and it was just so much fun and entrepreneurial. And I created something out of nothing. And, you know, here we are a decade later, and that leverage model still exists. And I take a lot of pride in that.
You know, I'm spending time thinking about 1876 contested elections. You know, it's good for me. I mean, you know, where else do you get paid to get smart?
The culture of Bridgewater is not only our competitive advantage, which has been the engine of our success for over 45 years. I've only been there for 17 of them. But it's also the reason that I've stayed all these years, because at the essence, it's about meaningful work and meaningful relationships that's built on radical truth and radical transparency.
And, you know, I genuinely think that, you know, we show up, we give our best for each other. And so because all of us, like, we care about this mission so much and care about this company and care about each other so much that we really, like, we put all of ourselves into it.
Realized early on that it would take a group, that one person couldn't build a community, that you needed a group of people that took on different responsibilities, but that it still all had to come together. And that it also needed the relationships, that we needed to actually build real relationships. It's a lot easier to take harsh feedback when you really believe that we're part of the same team trying to make each other better.
There's a myth that, you know, to be inclusive, you somehow have to sugarcoat or not tell it like it is. And I actually think that is in some ways the opposite of inclusion, or at least works against in the long term. Because so much of inclusion, I believe, is about, you know, the small ways that we're convinced to trust and to take risks and that we're safe. And so who are the people and what are the circumstances where we trust? I think it's actually the people who tell it like it is, who are open, who are honest, who are encouraging.
It's humbling as heck. You know, it's some of the smartest people I've ever worked with, and they question everything. So everything you think you know, you have to re-examine. But it's also been one of the warmest places I've ever worked at. And I did not see that coming. I did not expect people to be calling me at home every couple of weeks saying, how's it going? I know you're onboarding via Zoom. So that's been really lovely. I'm working harder than I've ever worked in my life, but it's good.
We have made a big effort and now have really huge involvement in affinity groups and our community groups. About 40% of the company is a member of one or more affinity networks. The groups are open to everyone. We've had over 100 events and activities. We've brought in major speakers to foster dialogue and build external connections.
The ability to, within Bridgewater, find a community of people who you might share an experience with: food, culture, interests, news, community service targeted in specific areas, is really important as well in terms of just feeling like Bridgewater is a place that you have a really deep sense of connection and community.
I think the story of win is a story of impact.
When I first started in 2004, there were 150 people and I was the only woman investment associate. The thing that was different about Bridgewater was I had Giselle Wagner, who was the chief operating officer at the time, who built Bridgewater with Ray and Bob and Greg and Dan over the years. The investment that she made in me, and then as other people joined, people would assign mentors and mentees to new hires. the family would grow and grow. And so we enjoyed each other's company. It wasn't just like, oh yeah, let's all get together.
Pretty early on in my career, I realized that there was some situations where I really felt like myself. The goal of the Investment Women's Network and really all of our ERGs at Bridgewater is to make people feel like themselves the most amount of time.
This group has given me just, I don't know, it's been one of my favorite, I don't want to say roles, because I don't know if I classify it that, but it's just been my favorite, I'll say adventure, right? I've been able to work with, you know, so many different people that I haven't been able to work with normally in my everyday job. And it's just been, it's really just been awesome.
What is the goal that you're actually trying to achieve, which is, you know, enabling people to build a life and a career, have an environment in which they can thrive, and then give them support resources in times of great need. And if you actually put in place a strategy and solutions that achieve that, the correlation of that to employee satisfaction and retention is so high and so strong.
If I can see it, I can be it. And for me, just to see other women doing amazing things, it's so inspirational. Mentors should not underestimate the impact that they can have simply sometimes by just doing what they're doing.